He made it famous to the Western world. We hear about William Harvey, but we hardly hear about the name of Ibn Nafis, who 400 years before William Harvey spoke about the blood circulation and the production of milk. In the field of embryology, the Quran describes the various embryological stages of the human development in great detail in Surah Mu'minun, chapter number 23, verse number 12 to 14. It says that the human, we were nutfa, then we made it into an alaka, a mudga, a zama, that human being is created from a minute quantity of fluid. Then it made it into alaka, that is a leech-like substance, then made it into a chewed-like lump, then made it into bones, then clothed the bones with flesh. When this verse was showed in the early part of the 1980s to Dr. Keith Moore, who at that time happened to be the highest authority in the field of anatomy and embryology, he was the head of the department in the University of Toronto, he said that the description of the Quran is far superior to what modern embryology describes today instead of stage 1, 2, 3. And he said that it's not possible that any human being can mention these things in the Quran. This Quran has to be the word from Almighty God, and he has no objection in accepting Prophet Muhammad as the messenger of Almighty God. Time does not permit me to speak a lot about science. I'll just give one more example which is mentioned in the Quran. The Quran mentions in Surah Qiyamah, chapter number 75, verse number 3 and 4, that when the unbelievers say that how will Almighty God be able to reconstruct our bones after we are dead, we are buried, our bones have got disintegrated. On the day of judgment, how will Almighty God be able to reconstruct our bones? Almighty God replies in the Quran and says, tell them, Almighty God can not only reconstruct the bones, he can even reconstruct in perfect order the very tips of the fingers. What does Quran mean by saying God can not only reconstruct the bones, he can even reconstruct in perfect order the very tips of the fingers? It was in 1880 that Sir Francis Gold, he discovered the fingerprinting method. And he said that no two fingerprints, even in millions of people, are identical. And today, this fingerprinting method is used by the police to identify the criminal. It's used by CIA, by FBI, by the police worldwide. This Quran mentions 1400 years ago. Francis Bacon, a very famous philosopher, he said, little knowledge of science makes a person an atheist, but in-depth knowledge of science makes a person a believer in God. That is the reason today scientists are not eliminating God, they're eliminating models of God. La ilaha illallah. There's no God but Allah.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम.
क्या बात है, कोई ख़ास काम कर रहे हो क्या?
हाँ, देख रहा हूँ कि अपनी ज़कात की रकम कहाँ दूँ.
पीस टीवी. पीस टीवी उर्दू से बेहतर क्या हो सकता है?
ज़कात और पीस टीवी उर्दू?
टीवी चैनल?
मैं कुछ समझा नहीं.
मैं समझाता हूँ, अगर टीवी चैनल इस्लामी है तो क्यों नहीं.
कई मोतबर उलमाए किराम का फतवा है कि हम गैर मुनाफा बख्श इस्लामी सैटेलाइट टेलीविजन चैनल जिसका मकसद इस्लाम की तालीमात को फैलाना है उसे अपनी ज़कात दे सकते हैं.
इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि हम फरीज़ाए ज़कात अदा करने के साथ साथ इस्लाम के पैगाम को फैलाने में भी मदद कर सकते हैं.
ज़रूर कर सकते हैं.
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, ये तो ऐसे हुआ जैसे सोने पे सुहागा.
पीस टीवी उर्दू का ताबुन करें. आप अपनी जकात और इमदाद की रकम भेज सकते हैं IRFI अल रायान बैंक, क्वाड्रेंट कोर्ट 48 कैंथोप रोड, बर्मिंगम, UK, पोस्ट कोड B151TH, पाउंड अकाउंट नंबर 01132301, यूरो अकाउंट नंबर 01132302, US डॉलर अकाउंट नंबर 01132303, सॉल्ट कोड 300083, स्विफ्ट BIC कोड IBOBGB22, IBAN GB52 Lloyd 3096340102412. Telephone ke zariye rakam bhejne ke liye +44 208 242 4321. Aap apni bheji hui imdad ki jankari admin@peacetv.tv par de.
Aaiye Peace TV Urdu ke zariye Islam ke paigham ko phailane mein हमारे साथ शामिल हो जाइए।
अस्सलामु अलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। मैं हाफिज अब्दुल कदीर उमरी और आप देख रहे हैं पीस टीवी उर्दू।
पीस टीवी उर्दू, अमन का पैगाम इंसानियत के नाम। कुरान की आयात को, रसूल की हर बात को मोमिन ही समझता है। ज़कात के अहकाम को
इस्लाम ने इसको किस कदर अहमियत दी है, कौन कौन सी खैरखाई है जो खाई है।
डॉक्टर मोहम्मद हम्माद लखवी,
जो इस्लाम ज़कात के जरिए करता है।
ज़कात की बड़ी अहमियत है ताकि एक मुसलमान का सारा माल अल्लाह ताला के यहाँ पाक तसव्वुर हो।
माल की पाकी और हिफाजत के लिए, मुसलमानों की तरक्की के लिए, ईमान की पुख्तगी के लिए
ज़कात से अच्छे खसाइल पैदा होते हैं। सखावत है, इंसानियत के साथ हमदर्दी है।
ज़कात की अदायगी जरूरी है मोमिनाना जिंदगी के लिए।
ज़कात अल्लाह ताला ने जो आयत की है
हाफिज सलाउद्दीन यूसुफ,
तो वो टैक्स नहीं है, ये एक इबादत है।
जानिए उस अहम इबादत का मकसद जिससे समर जाएंगे मुसलमानों के हालात। अहकाम ज़कात हर सनीचर रात 7:30 बजे और दोबारा रात 2:30 बजे इंडिया में पीस टीवी उर्दू पर।
I started my talk by quoting a verse from the Quran, from Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49. Verse number 13, which says, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min zakin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila litarafu inna akramakum indallahi atqakum inna allaha alimun khabir. Which means, O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you shall recognize each other, not that you shall despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Almighty God is the person who has taqwa. The criteria for judgment in the sight of Almighty God, it's not sex, it's not color, it's not wealth, it's not age, but it is taqwa, it is God consciousness, it's piety, it is righteousness. The only way one human being can be superior to the other human being is by righteousness and by piety, and no other criteria. Quran says in Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse number 22, amongst his signs, he has created the heavens and the earth, and the variation in your languages and color. These are signs for the people who understand. The Quran says he has created the different variation in the color and the languages so that those who are knowledgeable people, they will know it's a sign from Almighty God. This speaks about the universal brotherhood, that Almighty God has created all the human beings from a common pair of human beings, Adam and Eve. May peace be upon them. And Almighty God says in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 70, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَا, and we have honored the children of Adam. Almighty God says in the Quran that all the children of Adam, irrespective whether they're black or white, male or female, whether they're born in UK or India or USA, whichever part of the world they belong to, Almighty God has honored all the children of Adam, all the human beings. And Islam does not only speak about universal brotherhood, it practically demonstrates that every Muslim who follows the religion of Islam should practically practice it minimum 5 times in the day. I'm talking about one of the pillars of Islam, that is Salah, which is the prayer. And a beloved prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that when you stand for prayer, you should stand shoulder to shoulder. Irrespective whether the person standing next to you is black or white, rich or poor, king or pauper, when you stand for prayer, you have to stand shoulder to shoulder. This demonstrates the universal brotherhood every day, minimum 5 times a day. And another example is Hajj, which is one of the pillars of Islam, that every rich person who has the means and who has the health to travel to Makkah for the pilgrimage should at least do it once in his lifetime. And Hajj is the biggest annual gathering in the world, where about 3 to 4 million people from different parts of the world, from USA, from Canada, from UK, from India, from Malaysia, from different parts of the world, they gather together in one place in Makkah and Arafat, and they are dressed in 2 pieces of unsewn cloth, which is white in color. You cannot identify the person standing next to you as king or a pauper. And all of them come on a common statement. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Here we are, O my Lord, here we are at your service. Islam practically demonstrates universal brotherhood. Many religions believe that humankind has been created from a single pair of Adam and Eve. May peace be upon them both. But there are some religions who put the blame only on Eve for the downfall of humanity, for the original sin. But if you read the Quran, the blame for disobeying Almighty God is equally put on both Adam and Eve. May peace be upon them. The Quran says in Surah Araf chapter 7, verse number 19 to 27, Adam and Eve, peace be upon them, they are both addressed more than 12 times. Both of them, they disobeyed God. Both of them repented and both were forgiven. The blame is equally put on both of them. There is not a single verse in the Quran which puts the blame only on Eve. However, there's one verse in the Quran in Surah Taha, chapter 20, verse 121, which says, and singles out Adam, peace be upon him, and says, he disobeyed God. But on the whole, if you read the Quran, the blame is equally put on both of them. There are some religions who, because they say that woman is the cause of the downfall of humanity, which Islam doesn't agree, some religions say, because of that, God punished her. And pregnancy is a curse and punishment of God on the woman. But in Islam, pregnancy uplifts the woman. The Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 1, respect the womb that bore you. The Quran says in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 14, we have enjoined on the human beings to be kind to the parents. In travail upon travail did the mother bore them, and in years twain was the weaning. The Quran repeats the message in Surah Ahqaf, chapter number 46, verse number 15, we have enjoined on the human beings to be good to the parents. In pain did the mother bear them, and in pain did she give them birth. So pregnancy uplifts a woman, does not degrade her. And our beloved prophet said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari is one of the collections of the authentic sayings of the last and final messenger prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. It's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 8, in the Book of Manners, chapter number 2, hadith number 2. A man approaches the prophet and asks him that who deserves the maximum companionship and love in this world? Prophet said, your mother. The man asked, after that who? The prophet repeated, your mother. The man asked, after that who? Again the prophet said, your mother. The man asked for the 4th time, after that who? Then the prophet said, your father. That means 75%, 3/4 of the companionship goes to the mother, 25%, 1/4 goes to the father. In short, the mother gets the gold medal, she gets the silver medal, as well as the bronze medal. The father has to be satisfied with a mere consolation prize. These are the teachings of Islam which we have to agree. And if we analyze, Islam gave economic rights to women 1300 years before the Western world. 1400 years ago, Islam gave right to any adult Muslim woman to own or disown the property without the permission of anyone else. The first time the Western world gave right for a woman to own or disown property was in 1870s under the Married Woman Property Act, which said that a married woman, adult, can own or disown the property without the permission of the husband. And this act was later revised. Islam gave economic rights to women 1300 years before the Western world. And in Islam, we did not agree with the word housewife, which is used in English language, because we don't consider the woman to be married to the house to be called a housewife. We prefer calling her as homemaker, the person who makes the home, the person who builds the home. Though we see that there are many misconceptions, and many people think that men and women in Islam are not equal. In fact, in Islam, men and women are equal. But equality does not mean identicality. They're equal, but they are not identical. Depending upon the physiological makeup, their psychological makeup, their biological makeup, they have different roles. Overall, men and women are equal in some aspects. The woman, she may have a degree of advantage. In some aspects, the men may have a degree of advantage. Let me give you an example. If there are two students in a class, student A and B, both of them, they come out first in examination. Both get 80 out of 100. When we analyze the answer sheet, the 10 questions, which have 10 answers, each carrying 10 marks. In answer to question number one, student A gets 9 out of 10. Student B gets 10 out of 10. In answer to question number two, student B gets 9 out of 10, and student A, he gets 7 out of 10. In all the remaining 8 answers, both get 8 out of 10. If we add up, both get 80 out of 100, they're equal. But in answer number one, the student A has a degree of advantage. In answer number two, student B has a degree of advantage. In the other aspects, both are equal. And overall also, they're equal. In the same way, men and women in Islam are equal. In some aspects, the men have a degree of advantage. In some aspects, the women have a degree of advantage. For example, if a robber, if a thief enters my house, I will not say I believe in woman liberalization. I will not ask my wife or my daughter to go and fight. Since God has given me more strength, it is my duty to fight. As the Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4, verse 34, that God has given more strength to men. It is his duty to protect the woman. So in strength, the men have a degree of advantage. And the other example I gave earlier, that where companionship of the children is concerned for the parents, the women have 3 times more companionship as compared to men. The mother has 3 times more companionship as compared to father. So here, the women have a degree of advantage. So as I said earlier, men and women in Islam are equal. In some aspects, the women have a degree of advantage. In some aspect, the men have a degree of advantage.
ستیزہ کار رہا ہے ازل سے تا امروز چراغ مصطفی سے شرارب الحبی ازل سے جاری ہے ایک فکری و عملی کشمکش الہادی گمراہیوں کے اندھیرے ہیں ایک طرف اور اسلام کی روشنی ہے دوسری طرف اللہ ولی الذین آمنوا یخرجہم من الظلمات الی النور اللہ دوست ہے اہل ایمان کا نکالتا ہے ان کو ان اندھیروں سے نور اسلام کی طرف الحاد کہتے کس کو ہیں الحاد کی تاریخ اور اس کے اسباب و عوامل کیا ہیں اس کے نتائج اور عملی مظاہر کیسے معلوم ہو اور کیسے پہچان ہو نور اسلام کی دیکھیے ہمارا پروگرام الحاد اور اسلام
جانیے کس قدر بنیادی سچائی اور مضبوطی کے ساتھ تاریک دلوں کو روشن کر رہا ہے اللہ کی وحدانیت کا پیغام الہاد اور اسلام ہر بدھ رات 9:30 اور دوبارہ صبح 7:00 انڈیا میں پیس ٹی وی اردو پر تو مسلمان ہے تو اٹھ خود کو نمازی کر لے اپنے کردار سے اللہ کو راضی کر لے
عمل کیا جائے نماز کو اہمیت دی جائے زکوٰۃ ادا کیا جائے روزے رکھے جائیں اللہ نے مال دیا حج کے لیے جایا جائے
پاک سے
غیبت چغل خوری سے دور رہیں پڑوسیوں کے حقوق ادا کریں والدین کے حقوق ادا کریں
ساتھ سے
سود نہ کھائیں زنا نہ کریں ناپ تول میں کمی نہ کریں
اپنے ہر عمل سے عبادتوں کے اہتمام سے
جو رسول اللہ کی اطاعت کرتا ہے حقیقی معنوں میں وہ اللہ کی اطاعت کرتا ہے اللہ کی بات مانتا ہے
شیخ ثناء اللہ مدنی بتائیں گے عمل وہ جو ضروری ہے
ایسا ہی عمل سب سے اہم چیز ہے آج ہم اور آپ صحیح فضیلت سے لا علم ہیں
بنائیے کامیاب اپنا مستقبل و حال, فضائل اعمال کل شام 6:30 اور دوبارہ صبح 9:30 انڈیا میں پیس ٹی وی اردو پر.
کیا آپ کے ذہن میں ہے کچھ شکوک و شبہات؟ تو پھر دیکھیے پیس ٹی وی اردو پر حافظ مامون کے سوالات اور میرے جوابات. پروگرام ہے قرآن کے سائے میں, میں ہوں خلیل الرحمن چشتی.
جانیے زندگی کا وہ مکمل نظریہ جس میں اللہ نے بیان کیے ہیں احکامات دونوں جہان کی کامیابی کے بارے میں. قرآن کے سائے میں کل رات 9:30 اور دوبارہ صبح 7:00 انڈیا میں پیس ٹی وی اردو پر. ہر دور میں بڑھاتا جو مومن کی شان ہے, پیغام حق سمیتے ہمارا قرآن ہے.
اقیم الصلاۃ نماز کو قائم رکھو, اول و آخر جس شے کا ذکر ہے وہ ہے نماز.
ڈاکٹر عارف رشید اسرا.
کسی بھی مسلمان فرد کی زندگی کے اندر جو نمایاں ترین شے نظر آنی چاہیے وہ نماز کا معاملہ ہے.
ضروری ہے جس کا احترام,
جو قرآن میں فرمایا گیا اقیم الصلاۃ لذکری, نماز کو قائم رکھو تاکہ تمہارا دل میری یاد سے بسا رہے.
لازمی ہے جس پر عمل.
نماز تو وہ شے ہے کہ جو ہر فوش کام سے, ہر بے حیائی کے کام سے اور منکرات سے, گناہوں سے روکنے والی.
کامیابی ہے جس کی پناہ میں.
الذین هم فی صلاتهم خاشعون, وہ لوگ کہ جو اپنی نمازوں کے اندر خشوع و خضوع اختیار کرنے والے.
دنیا کو گمراہی سے نکالنے کے لیے رب نے اتارا کلام, قرآن کا پیغام ہر بدھ شام 4:00 اور دوبارہ صبح 4:30 انڈیا میں پیس ٹی وی اردو پر.
The foundation of the religion of Islam is the belief in one and only sole creator and sustainer. And this creator and sustainer, Almighty God, is the same for all the human beings. Only if you agree that our creator, sustainer and cherisher, one God, is the same, then only can brotherhood be maintained in all religions. And this is the basis of all the religions. Religion, according to Oxford Dictionary, means a belief in a superhuman controlling power, a personal god or gods that deserve worship and obedience. So according to Oxford Dictionary, religion means belief in God. If you understand God, you understand that religion in the right perspective. Quran says in Surah Al-Imran chapter 3 verse number 64, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَ بَيْنَكُمْ, come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, that we worship none but one Almighty God. So the Quran says, let the people of different religions come to common terms. What is different, we can discuss tomorrow. Let us agree to follow what is common. And one thing common in all the religion is to believe and worship only one God. To understand any religion or to understand the concept of God in a religion, it is not appropriate to try and observe the followers of that religion. Because many a time the followers themselves may not be aware about the religion or the concept of their God in religion. The best and the most authentic way of understanding a religion or understanding the concept of God in a religion is to try and understand what the authentic scriptures of that religion have to speak about God. Let's try and understand the concept of God in the major religions in a nutshell. First, we'll try to understand the concept of God in Hinduism. The two major and most authentic scriptures in the religion of Hinduism are the Vedas and the Upanishads. It's mentioned in the Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1. Ekam Evidityam, God is only one without a second. This is a Sanskrit quotation. It's mentioned in the Svetasetara Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9. ناچس سے کسج جنیتانا چدیپا آف دیٹ گاڈ ہی ہیز گاٹ نو پیرنٹس ہی ہیز گاٹ نو لارڈ ہی ہیز گاٹ نو فادر ہی ہیز گاٹ نو مدر ہی ہیز گاٹ نو سپیریئر اٹس مینشن ان دا سویتا سیتر اپنیشد چیپٹر نمبر 4 ورس نمبر 19 ایز ویل ایز یجروید چیپٹر نمبر 32 ورس نمبر 3 ن تسیہ پرتیما استی آف دیٹ گاڈ دیر از نو پرتیما پرتیما از اے سنسکرت ورڈ وچ مینس این امیج اے فوٹوگراف اے پینٹنگ اے پکچر اے اسکلپچر اے اسٹیچو این آئیڈل اٹ سیز آف دیٹ گاڈ دیر از نو امیج دیر از نو پکچر دیر از نو پینٹنگ دیر از نو پورٹریٹ دیر از نو اسٹیچو دیر از نو آئیڈل دیر از نو اسکلپچر اینڈ دا برہما سوترا آف ہندوئزم دا فنڈامنٹل کریڈ آف ہندوئزم از ایکم برہم دیوتیا ناستے نینا ناستے کنچن بھگوان ایک ہی ہے دوسرا نہیں ہے نہیں ہے نہیں ہے ذرا بھی نہیں ہے دیر از اونلی ون گاڈ ناٹ اے سیکنڈ ون ناٹ ایٹ آل ناٹ ایٹ آل ناٹ ان دا لیسٹ بٹ سو اف یو ریڈ دا ہندو اسکرپچرز یو شل انڈرسٹینڈ دا کانسپٹ آف گاڈ ان ہندوئزم اینڈ انڈرسٹینڈ ہندوئزم ان دا رائٹ پرسپیکٹو لیٹس ڈسکس دا کانسپٹ آف گاڈ ان جوڈائزم اٹس مینشن دا اولڈ ٹیسٹامنٹ ان دا بک آف ڈیوٹرانومی چیپٹر نمبر 6 ورس نمبر 4 Moses, peace be upon him, says, Shama Israelo, Adnahin Radnaikat, Yoro Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. It's mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 43, verse number 11. I am Lord, and there's no Savior besides me. It's mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 45, verse number 5. I am Lord, and there's none else, there's no God besides me. It's mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 46, verse number 9. I am God and there's none else. I am God and there's none like me. It's further mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter number 20, verse number 3 to 5, as well as in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 5, verse number 7 to 9. Almighty God says, Thou shalt have no other God besides me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image of anything, of any likeness in the heaven above, in the earth beneath, in the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for thy God, thy Lord, is a jealous God. So if you read the Old Testament,